coming. In the first set, we kind of, or I kind of, I tried to explain what we do, so I'm going to do it now again. This means sustain. This means continuous sound, one continuous sound. And from this directive, you can create a lot of things. You can create melody, drone, and a number of other things. I'll give you an example here.
Be careful, Miss.
Watch this. Be dumbfounding the music world because they say how did you write that? Well, I say, well, I didn't write it, but I did write it. They wrote it. I control the structure, they control the content, and that's what conduction is all about. This means repeat, this means sustain, this means repeat. So I'm asking the violinist and the bassist to repeat something. And repeat, if you don't know what it looks like in music theory, it's two brackets that look like that. You play something, and when you finish playing it, you go back to the beginning and you play it again. Philip Glass has made a living out of this. So I'm asking them to repeat something. Ready? And I'm going to give them a tempo. I don't always give them a tempo, but I'm going to give them a tempo. And this is the tempo. And I'm going to ask them to repeat something. I don't care what they repeat. I do, but they have to care as much as I do. Ready? Okay, so they're repeating. Go ahead! All right? So, I'm going to ask the viola and cello to repeat something. Whatever they think belongs to this. All right? And believe me, I have no idea what they're going to play. So, here's the tempo, and I want you to repeat something. Take your time, huh? Use space, all right? That I said, this is memory one. So when I want to hear that again, I tell them memory one. memory. I'm building ideas. Just ideas. So, and all these ideas are information. Information. Play your memory one. Ready? Okay, so, keep going. So, this sign has five meanings. And I'll show you another meaning for this sign. If I tell the other strings to repeat that, this is what happens. If I ask the ensemble to repeat this, this is what it sounds like. Okay, keep going. This means develop. I have some play it here. This means ghosting. Now, ghosting doesn't exist in the classical canon. It belongs in the jazz canon. Ghost notes. Ghost. Ghost. It doesn't only mean soft, but it means a note that you can't quite figure out. And when people annotate ghost note, they put an X with a value. This is another story. But anyway, I'm going to ask them to develop this information. And development, happens in a lot of different ways. You can make variation on the information, or you can develop things in a lot of different ways. So watch this. Watch. This is the way they're developing their information. When I want to go back to the original information, I go here. I'll show you. And then we go back. Okay, so you see, so we did sustain, we did repeat, we did memory, and we did development. But there's a lot of other really, really simple things that don't belong to the traditional musical canon. And I said, ghosting. But watch this. Let's do memory one. Let's ghost memory one. But ghosting, please. Ghost doesn't mean to just play soft. It just means ghost note. Please. We're going to ghost memory one. Ready? Of dynamics, like louder and softer, but I'm saying piano, 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 and forte, 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 forte. So, This is how we create what we do. So, just to give you an example. So, when you hear things happen, you hear things happen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Going to repeat. Okay. Good night.